when JD comes back, he's off in one of his technical functions. His capacities.
Yeah.
We assume the studio just works. He might be coming back. He might be here. I'm going to ask him about the studio of the future or his imagination. Because obviously, you know, the studio is working at the moment because you're in here talking to us.
Yeah.
Stay near the microphone, JD.
I would if it was on.
Oh. Okay. Come over to this one.
Yes. That's better. Yeah.
That's all right.
Yep.
Okay. Now listen.
I am.
Forget about this studio. Just imagine.
You can have Mike too if you want.
Oh, that's all right.
Oh, I can have Mike too. Wow.
Okay.
And I'm honoured.
Now. I know you're preoccupied with all the technical features that keep this studio going, but I would just like you to imagine a studio of the future which could operate in various ways. I think the safest way would be on a two-hour delay. We upload an MP3 somewhere in the sky and the robots take over and re-edit it a bit. They replace various tracks with later versions. They consult with record companies, agencies, and get permission for things. And do you think that would be a good idea? Sorry, I'm putting the question to JD, Chris, but you are allowed to comment, obviously.
Oh, thank you. I think that would be a good idea, but you're getting the robot to do a lot.
I don't think so.
I think you have expectations of robots.
Chris, I don't think you realise how far the robots have
this
taken
is the
over already.
Of the day, boys and girls. Here they go.
Chris, the robots are all around us anyway.
Yeah.
We just have to recognise them and try and work with them.
Okay.
They could take this show.
Do you know Will's a robot? You didn't know that, did you?
Will.
I'll unplug him if you want to from the wall for half an hour and then carry on.
No, it happens already. You try and upload a clip you've innocently created to a well-known video online, whatever, and you immediately get loads of messages saying the copyright is owned by somebody else and the advertising's being allocated to, and so on and so forth. Well, why don't we just upload this show? I mean, well, obviously, we're paying all the proper fees. Phonic FM management have got it all sorted anyway.
Yeah, they have.
But couldn't we upload what we've done so far? And somebody would say, well, actually, there's an even more recent track from Martha and the Mechanics or whoever it was.
Martha and the Muffins, and there probably is a more recent track, but I thought it was a nice...
Oh, there's nothing wrong with that track, Chris. I'm just saying that the robots, with all their connections, will come up with a different show.
Okay.
And they should have their chance, just like anyone else. And we wouldn't need a studio, so that would be another saving, because whatever sort of show we came up with, the robots would just replace most of it anyway.
So, Will, you're making everyone's job non-existent.
No, there'd still be the basis of something. The robots can't do anything without an input.
Okay.
So we'd input something at whatever level of technical competence.
Okay.
And they would take over from there.
Okay.
And the audience would have to decide which robot they wanted to work with.
Well, yes. Let the audience decide they want to work with Chris Norton. And here is a song for Becky. It is Erasure. I love you to the sky and back, or something. I'll tell you afterwards.